Because how can we love God whom we don't see? St. John says, how can you say that you love God whom you don't see if you do not love your neighbor whom you see? Jesus said, I was hungry.
What's up, guys? My name is Tom. Many of you was wondering who's behind that top channel logo, so here I am. You didn't think I was about to fly my drone in this location, did you? No.
For the tender concern of somebody.
I'm really enjoying having this channel, just like you enjoy watching these.
I was naked, and you clothed me. Not only with a piece of cloth. Nakedness is that loss of that beautiful human dignity of the child of God. The dignity that have been created to love and to be loved. The dignity of that beautiful virtue, purity. That we keep our purity pure. That we keep our chastity chaste. That we keep our virginity virgin. This is a nakedness, and that is lost. I was homeless, and you took me in. Not only for a house made of bricks, a wife homeless, unwanted, unloved, a throwaway of society. But today we have right here in our country. We see the poor people, we see the young people with that disease, unwanted, unloved, a throwaway of society. Are we there to be that love, that kindness, that thoughtfulness to them and share with them the terrible pain, the terrible feeling of terrible loneliness? Be a throwaway. Have no one to be somebody to somebody. This is the nativity of Jesus. Being poor, being born as a poor. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Thank you.
Is y'all motherfuckers ready to take a trip through our world? A world where drugs is dealt, top notches get killed, and homeboys get killed. It gets deep, partner. So if you down with it, you need to strap on in and ride this bitch on out. And we gon' all get high. It's big drink, pounds of dank, and we gon' party till we break your bank. And oh yeah, if they ask, you tell them that you live in the Golden State.
States intelligence community, and what does it do? Often referred to as the IC, America's intelligence community is essential to America's security at home and abroad. By its nature, the work of the IC is secretive, but that doesn't mean we know nothing about it. The U.S. intelligence community is a group of 16 separate U.S. government agencies that work together and independently to support America's foreign policy and national security. All are overseen by the Director of National Intelligence, or the ODNI. The Director of National Intelligence, a position created in 2014, reports directly to lawmakers and the President of the United States to inform policy and defense operations. There are standalone national intelligence agencies, agencies that work under the umbrella of the Department of Defense, and agencies that serve within federal departments. The only wholly independent intelligence agency in the U.S. government is also its most famous, the Central Intelligence Agency. The CIA is responsible primarily for human intelligence collection, or HUMINT, both in the U.S. and abroad. But plainly, their business is recruiting spies and stealing secrets. There are also intelligence agencies that are part of the Department of Defense. Each branch of the military has their own intel agency within their service. These agencies gather intelligence in support of military operations for each of their branches. Some intelligence agencies are not part of just one military branch, but support the DoD as a whole. Lastly, There are intelligence agencies that inform and operate as part of larger federal agencies and departments. Together, these 16 organizations work both together and separately, at home and abroad, to inform policymakers, bolster our military, and protect the nation and its people.
Welcome to DOT Security's physical location, the Security Operations Center. Normally, this facility is close to the public, but today, we're going to bring you on a virtual tour so you can check out how awesome this place is. Let's go. I wasn't kidding when I said that we were close to the public. At the entrance, you have to verify your identity several times through multiple methods just to get into the building. We believe that one of the great benefits of having a physical building for our Security Operations Center is that it creates opportunities for our professionals to talk, exchange ideas, and share updates from their cybersecurity specialties. That's why we created this lounge space specifically for that. In these offices, they help you create a customized security strategy, advise you about what's coming in the world of cybersecurity, and help you train your colleagues and employees in best practices. We engage in continuous training and education right here in our training room, so we give all our team members the knowledge and tools they'll need to succeed as they keep moving up in their careers. And now, let's go where the magic really happens. This is the heart of the Security Operations Center, the main floor, or what we refer to as the Command Center. It's where our cybersecurity analysts and penetration testers operate. They monitor your network, handle alerts, test to ensure it's well fortified, perform risk assessments, and so much more. This almost 2,000 square foot LED screen displays critical information including threat intelligence, ticketing information, internet outages, managed detection response, and persistence detection capability information, which is critical for the security team. That's DOT Security's Operations Center. As you can see, this is a building that was intentionally constructed to sustain operations to provide effective cybersecurity and compliance services to our clients. If you're interested in partnering with DOT Security, contact a sales specialist today.
The people here at DOT Security, first and foremost, if I had to say one word of what they mean, that's family. When I walk in the morning, I'm genuinely excited to see people. One thing that I really enjoy in the morning is to say hi to our morning crew that's here, to all of those team members that decided to show up early. I deeply, deeply love being a leader and a champion for my team, and when they give me that embrace and those kudos back, there are very few things that I find more rewarding. It's really important to think about that what we're doing is we're helping organizations put safety and security controls in place to prevent loss of livelihood. And once we figure out a path to trying to overcome those hurdles, trying to do the best that we can so that we can all share in the results and wins together.
Now, the word of the Lord. It says this, and I want to read from Ezekiel. Son of man, set your face toward Gog in the land of Magog, the chief prince of Meshech and Tubal. Prophesy against him and say, this is what the Lord God says. Behold, I am against you, Gog, chief prince of Meshech and Tubal. So I'll turn you around and put hooks into your jaws and bring you out. And all your army, horses and horsemen, all of them magnificently dressed, a great contingent with them, Persia, Cush, and Put, all of them with buckler and helmet, Gomer with all his troops, Beth Togarmah from the remote parts of the north with his troops, many people with you. Now, I want to show you the map of what we're looking at right now. I want to give you the perspective. Now, if you look quickly, you see Ukraine, that's the blue. You've got Poland, you've got the Baltic states in there. You've got the Russian satellites. You've got Azerbaijan, Armenia, Turkey. And across the Crimea, it looks like all for years the Russians have wanted to get out of the Sea of Azov into the Black Sea and in turn into the Mediterranean. And if they do, there's a choke point you see between Bulgaria, Turkey, and Greece. And you've got on the right-hand side Turkey, and on the left-hand side you've got the Crimea and you've got the Baltic. Now, what we've got to look at, I want to show you again the map of what's there, and then we want to take a look at what the Bible has to say. The Bible says it will come about in that day when Gog comes against the land of Israel, declares the Lord, that my fury will mount up in my anger, in my zeal, in my blazing wrath. I declare that on that day there will be a great earthquake in the land of Israel. The fish of the sea, the birds of the air, of the sky, the animals of the field, all the crawling things, and all mankind who are on the face of the earth will be shaken by presence, and the mountains will be thrown down, the steep pathways and every wall will fall to the ground, and I will call for a sword against him on all my mountains, declares the Lord. Every man's sword will be against his brother. With plague and with blood I will enter into judgment with him, and I will rain on him and his troops and on the many people who are with him a torrential rain, hailstones, fire, and brimstone. Now, again, let's take a look at that map behind me. I think you need to understand what's there. There we're looking at the situation as it exists. You see Ukraine, and then you see the Black Sea, and you see the Mediterranean, and you see a land bridge from Russia across into the cities that are listed in the Bible. Now, Ukraine is key because they have a land bridge between Russia and Turkey. And you've got Erdogan, who's the dictator in Turkey, and you've got Putin now coming into Russia. And those nations are going to be lined up, the so-called Rush. Now, here's what the Bible, the biblical names of those places are. So let's take a look again at what the Bible says. Rush is up there in the southern part of Russia. Magog, you look at Uzbekistan, Turkestan, Azerbaijan, Armenia, and Kazakhstan. That's all in that Magog area. Persia is Togarma and Tubal, you see right there. And then the North Sudan is so-called Kush. Now, all the troops there are going to be coming against Israel in the latter days. And God says, I am going to take care of it. But why is Putin insane? Well, yes and no, because he is being driven to move against Israel because God says, I'm going to put hooks in your jaws. I'm going to bring you down on them. Now, you get the picture. Again, I want to get that map one more time to show the relationship. You see, there's Ukraine, and there is the Mediterranean, and there is the Crimea and the Black Sea. And you see that little land bridge between the Black Sea and, it says, Greece and Bulgaria. On the one hand, you've got Putin and his troops. On the other hand, you have Erdogan and the people in Turkey. And those together will be making up this tremendous army in the latter days. And I think you can say, well, Putin's out of his mind. Yes, maybe so. But at the same time, he's being compelled by God. He went into the Ukraine, but that wasn't his goal. His goal was to move against Israel ultimately. And he will link up with Turkey, with Azerbaijan, I mean with across the Dardanelles, and that little bridge, and they will come together. And then you look down into North Sudan, and you've got a Muslim country down there, and there they all are. Persia, of course, is Iran, and there is the land that is set up in Ezekiel 38, and you see how Ukraine is key because of the, you see the land bridge between Bulgaria, Greece, and Turkey, and all of that area is going to be mobilized against Israel in the latter days, and God says, I am going to deal with it. So you can look at your map, you can read your newspaper, you can listen to your news, but know of a fact that God is bringing to pass what he prophesied years ago through his servant Ezekiel. And you read it in the 38th passage of Ezekiel 1 through 6. It's all there. And God is getting ready to do something amazing. And that will be fulfilled. And what Putin is doing is by moving as he is to set up Ukraine as a staging ground for one of the armies. And then across is Erdogan at Turkey. And you've got between them that little Dardanelles area, and it's going to happen. So I just say that is what's coming up. Is Putin crazy? Is he mad? Well, perhaps. But God says, I'm going to put hooks in your jaws, or I'm going to draw you into this battle, whether you like it or not. And he's being compelled, after the move into the Ukraine, he's being compelled to move again to get a land bridge and then across the Dardanelles with Turkey, and watch what's going to happen next. You read your Bible, because it's coming to pass.